Muslims are born in our land. So Indian wisdom is the only appropriate tribute and health. No other things you call are qualified wisdom gifts. So this is a problem with the relations. Then one more thing is sutra ki. There is a sutra. Sutra means string. I have already told in one seminar that you cannot expect everything as per your own demand or your own need. There is also one flexibility required. There are some qualities, special qualities known as sacrifice. Yes, I don't want that. Instead of everybody is conventionally getting things, why can't I give? Everybody is gaining things and enjoying. Why can't I have the same pleasure by using it for a productive cause? That is sacrifice. Second thing is contentment. Third thing is mercy. Fourth thing is flexibility. These are all the qualities which are essential. There is no strong, such a straight route in which we can be just assembling things and achieving things without any stopgap. There is no such thing at all. We must have flexibility so that we can adjust with people. We must have contentment in resources. We must have mercy towards other people also. And we must have the mentality of sacrifice as a positive replacement for avarice. It is a positive replacement for avarice, in which we love to lose more, in which we gain by losing. That type of sacrifice, that is the intuition of our land. And likewise, in this string theory of relation, like father, mother, children, then grandchildren, relations, friend circles, innumerable friend circles are there. So all of these people, they form a string in the society. Vasudhaiva Kutumbaka means that there is a string. Mahasutra. There you must have adjustment. You must have forgiving things, you must have the forgetting mentality. These type of qualities are very essential in the string theory, and it is not there. And coming to professional status, professional environment is a very competitive environment. We have competition, we have jealousy, we have competition, we have jealousy, we have domination, and we have discrimination. Office means we cannot say that, oh, it is ergonomically constructed, it is having rich infrastructure, everything is air conditioned and sophisticated machinery. We cannot think like that. We need not just imagine an office in which we get only salary, we do only work. Apart from the infrastructure, apart from your subordinates, superordinates and coordinates, you have to work with four more people as well now. You have to work with competition, jealousy, discrimination and domination. Those things are there. You must not just think that, oh, I am very loyal, I am very truthful. So loyalty and quality, they are not the mere essentials by which we can run the show. And even if you are good, there are three more possibilities. Associate, associated and merged. Even if you are proper, the associates, they need not be proper. And even if you are proper, the associated people with you personally, if they commit any blunder, that will come on your head. And merge, there is a total merge in the society, like most of the society, the major society is towards corruption and malpractices. But still, that's what I told in a seminar on ethics. What is the benefit of ethics? The benefit of ethics is not the favor of God, it is not getting a good birth, it is not getting into heaven or liberation. These things may be remote benefits. The benefit of ethicism is to be proud that we are ethical, that we are principled. That is the benefit of ethics. And going to heaven, liberation, getting divine sanction and embrace, these things are remote benefits. So we have to cultivate these things also. And coming into the real conclusion session, there are three insecurities. For life management, we must not only understand this resources side, we have to understand also the problems. It is known as problem analysis, success investigation and failure investigation. So there are three major hindrances for that. Number one is health insecurity, second is wealth insecurity, third thing is life insecurity. What is health insecurity? Due to mismanagement of resources, emotions and exercises or habits, we have got all diseases. Now whatever diseases, somebody asked, I think that Ganeshan, he asked, does somebody send a message for a normal delivery, seeking blessings for a normal delivery? Then I asked the question, what they meant by normal delivery? Then they told, without cesarean is normal delivery. Then I told that this is not the correct contemporary trend. Getting cesarean birth is a normal delivery, and if you don't get cesarean birth, that is abnormal delivery. So, diabetes, hypertension, hyperacidity, blood pressure, these things are occasional and rare diseases. These things were before few decades. Now it is very common and conventional. It is surprising and shocking to know if somebody is not having diabetes or blood pressure. So these things are common hazards. Then seasonal hazards, even seasonal, normal, now we are hearing new fevers, new viral attacks. A fever for 10 days that lasts for 2 months, and even after the fever has gone, 6 months of aftermath impact that touches us. So common hazards, seasonal hazards, and various infections and fatal diseases. So we don't have any health assurance. So there is a book written by a scientist, Efrald. He has written a book known as Death by Medicine. Most of the people, they die only by wrong diagnosis and wrong treatments. So there is a shloka also. Namastu bhyam vaidyaraja yamaraja sahodra. Yamastu harate pranam tvam pranam dharame vacha. Which says that doctor is the big brother of Lord Yama. And Yama captivates only the life, whereas the doctor takes the life as well as money. So this type of health insecurity is there. And second thing is wealth insecurity. We have fraudulence, we have acquisition, we have loss of wealth. Innumerable things are there for wealth also. In wealth also we are now developing a lot of things. One is, I have delivered a lecture on onto-economics. Certainly that must be distributed to all for understanding the real value of wealth. One is saving, second is insurance, third is standardization. We have to standardize the way of living. For example, to make a child to enter and complete LKG, the expenses incurred is as equal to a middle class family expenses. How we have to standardize, you see, where in a country, food and water, education, as well as medicine is sold, that is not the abode of luxury. So this thing, they must be minimized. It creates a bubble. How? See, if we have to pay more, not for luxuries, even for needs like medication, education, for internal perfection, you require education. For external peripheral perfection, you need medication. These both things are really great essentials for human life. So if there is, for shelter, for even food, for even education, medication, if it creates, if it demands more wealth, then they have to work more, they have to earn more. More than their capability, more than their real brain value, they have to extend their elasticity and work. This creates a bulb. This bulb creates a bulge. This bulge creates a bubble. The bubble creates a burst. A lot of these bubbles, they burst in the society, creating global recession now. And coming to the third thing, life insecurity. Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam. So this is the philosophy. Now it has become the part of human life. Any time we are ready to die at any cost, at any place due to any other factor, unpredictable factor, we are ready to die. We have to die. That's what I told you in seminar on terrorism. I told, if a city is not attacked by the terrorists, please don't think that the protection measures or the other vigilance and surveillance mechanisms of the city is safeguarding the city. Don't think like that. We are living by the mercy of the terrorists. If they are not attacking the city, means